Hello and thank you for joining me. My name is Brett Kingman and this is the NERO Fuzz from Cornerstone Audio Gear. Emilio and the lads sent this to me and said, would you mind having a look at it and a listen to it, please? And if you like it, give it a bit of airtime. And I actually love it. It's fantastic. So what we've got here is something reminiscent of Fuzz Face, I suppose you could say. But unlike a Fuzz Face, it has high impedance input, so you can put it in anywhere you want in the effects loop. It also has two voice controls, which you can switch between the white voice or the red voice. And the white voice is over here on the left. They're both the same voice, but you can kind of tweak them to be a little bit different. Then we've got the volume control and the gain control and the tone control and a compression control. And the compression control is very clever. They've built the Gladio SC for single channel circuit into this pedal, so you get a little bit of the clean as well. Another thing, and I know I'm raving on, we'll have a listen to it very, very shortly, but it works differently, of course, with different amp platforms. So I've chosen four different amp platforms today because I think it's worthwhile hearing it on those different platforms, and they are, and all courtesy of the XFX3, which is unbelievably accurate and very handy in here. We've got the JTM45. We've got an AC30. We've got a deluxe reverb. And we've got the 1959 Super Lead Plexi. This guitar was built for me by John Paler back in 2013. We called it the Apple Tree. And it has some Simulcaster T90 pickups, which are wound for me by Ben Bailey over here at JJ's Guitar Pickups in South Australia. Ben does amazing stuff. Check out his website. I use his pickups in most of my stage and touring and actually YouTube guitars as well. All right, this guy, let's turn him on. Actually, I'll just backtrack there. We'll start with the JTM45 because it's a bit cleaner. That's a good sound. I'd be happy just with that. But I can swipe with the voice control. So you've got a red voice and a white voice. The white voice is tuned down completely anti-clockwise and the red voice is tuned up completely clockwise. And now the differences, despite those extreme settings, are pretty subtle. So there's something about the bottom end when it's all the way wound out. It just seems a little bit fuller. So, but the differences are subtle, and I'm wondering whether that depends on where your volume knob is set on the guitar and, of course, the type of amp platform that you're using and the gain. So let's start with the gain all the way down. And just the bypassed sound again. Note that I've got my voice control, which is the white voice, down, all the way down. Let's go to noon. We'll start it at noon. Gain up to midday. Now, gain all the way up. It's going to get noisy because it's driving a Marshall. It's still got a nice fast attack. It's not having any problems with my blisteringly fast licks. Ha, only joking. Now we've got this compression control, and at the moment the compression is wound. But when I wind it in, you can feel it under your fingers, and it's really more about the feel than the sound. We'll be right back. Do you hear it open up then when I turned it anti-clockwise? It's because there's more headroom. I'm going to drive that voice control all the way to the right. Wind this guitar's volume back. Noon seems to be the good spot. Tone control wise. Tone is actually adding to the gain as well. Alright, so that's what it's going to sound like if you have a JTM45 based amplifier in your arsenal. It'll sound pretty darn close to that. Let's go to the Deluxe Reverb, which is a completely different beast. It has a natural compression, a much smoother top end. Sounds like this. That to me is reminiscent of somewhere between a fuzz and an overdrive pedal, which is kind of a complex sound, but very, very appealing to my ears. You can get that kind of saggy fuzz thing going on if you crank the gain a little bit and up the compression. The compression feature is, you know, quite unique, I think, and a lot of fun. It's a good sound. It's a very good sound. I'm impressed, Emilio. I like this pedal a lot. Let's go now to the other extreme, a 1959 Super Lead Plexi, which is already, you know, distorted and lacking in headroom because it's full tilt. So it's acting like a fuzz face normally would with, you know, a hot-rodded Marshall amp or a classic old Plexi along the lines of the model in the AX. Go to the AC30. Thank you. The NERO Fuzz from Cornerstone Audio Gear is going to appeal to a lot of people who don't normally like, you know, the kind of gritty, gated, sputtery fuzz. This is more along the lines of an old school overdrive that sits well with any particular amp platform. And I've just covered JTM 45 through to AC30, and they're quite different circuits and sounds. And it's happy with either of them, with all of them actually, including the deluxe reverb. The other great feature of the NERO Fuzz is that it has that impedance facility to be able to pop it wherever you want in your signal path on your pedal board. It's very good, but that's to be expected because all the Cornerstone stuff is very good. Thank you for watching. I'll take you out with a bit more of my Doobies jam. See you soon.